second award, also for practitioners, goes to Marcedonio Cortave.
Under the vision that in order to sustain the forests, the communities have to be sustained and consolidated first, Marcedonio Cortave is probably one of the most important activists on community management of natural resources in Guatemala. His work dates back to 1990, when facing the creation of the Reserva de la Biosfera Maya, the Mayan Biosphere Reserve, he helped create a wide community movement which successfully fought for the recognition and acknowledgement of communities' management and use rights over resources. This fight has been consolidated in the creation of the Asociación de Comunidades Forestales de Petén, the Association of Petén Forest Communities, ACOFOP, a structure of 22 organizations which benefit 15,000 people directly and 70,000 indirectly. This association has negotiated with the Guatemalan government the creation of 9 units of land management covering about 352,000 hectares and is still fighting to gain access and management of another 71,000. Creating a community forest management model which facilitates the use of timber and non-timber resources as well as the provision of environmental services and generating employment for community farmers, fulfilling the standards of the Forest Stewardship Council. In addition, this management model covers 132,000 hectares of private management. Marcedonio's work has faced many external pressures throughout the years, from oil and corporate interests to huge tourist projects with little or no social benefit, and the fact that they work in a border region with important problems with illicit trafficking of goods. Nevertheless, he and ACOFOP have worked intensively to propose innovative alternatives which protect community rights and promote local economic development, creating a world-renowned model. Under Marcedonio's leadership, ACOFOP has developed a model that has time and again proved that communities have the technical and administrative capabilities to manage their resources successfully and sustainably, which has resulted in this model being studied worldwide and used to inspire others in different regions of Africa, South America, and Asia. The model has been awarded 5 times, both nationally and internationally, with distinctions such as the recognition from the UN Development Program for Biodiversity Conservation and Poverty Reduction, the Presidential Environmental Medal, by the Government of Guatemala in 2003, and recognition by the Rainforest Alliance for Biodiversity Protection through Community Organization. It has also given Mr. Cortave over 15 international recognitions and awards. Marcedonio Cortave has also been one of the leaders who has contributed to the development of the Alianza Nacional de Organizaciones Comunitarias de Guatemala, the National Alliance of Guatemalan Community Organizations, with over 300 grassroots organizations, 64,000 members, and over 300,000 indirect beneficiaries. He's also contributed to the creation of the Alianza Mesoamericana de Pueblos y Bosques, the Mesoamerican Alliance of Peoples and Forests, with 10 second-level organizations and partners from Panama to Mexico, proving that collective action, negotiation, and dialogue are powerful tools to protect natural resources. I'm very honored to present this award to Marcedonio Cortave.
En Guatemala, en Centroamérica, hemos desarrollado un proceso de manejo forestal comunitario que hace 25 años nadie creía que las comunidades podían manejar el bosque y sostenerlo para el bien común. Después de muchos años, hoy día está demostrado que las comunidades pueden manejar el bosque, pueden tener una armonización y un equilibrio entre el bienestar social y el bienestar económico y el bienestar ecológico ambiental de este planeta. Hoy día no lo decimos nosotros, lo dice el satélite, que el bosque que está en manos de comunidades está ahí presente, no solo en su cobertura forestal, sino en la conservación de la biodiversidad interna y en el bienestar socioeconómico de las familias. Es por ello que a mucha honra y con mucho honor recibo este reconocimiento, no para mí, sino en nombre de mi familia y en nombre de 15,000 comunitarios y comunitarias que han luchado por mantener el bosque en Petén, Guatemala. Y gracias a la memoria y honrar a Elinor Ostrom por crear este premio y por inspirarnos para seguir luchando con los comunes en el mundo y seguir manteniendo la sostenibilidad de los recursos naturales y el bienestar social. Muchas gracias.